What's good, YouTube? And today we're working on these all coastal white Steve Madden's. And when I tell y'all, the before and after shots will shock your mind. So stay tuned after these messages. So today we're working on these all-white Steve Madden's, and when I tell y'all, these are one of my favorite pair of shoes, man. I love these, because they're all-white, and you can wear them with anything. But as you can see, I got them dirty. I've worn them a few times. So for this video, I only need the right shoe, so we're gonna move this left shoe out the way. Move, get out the way. And we're going to remove the shoelaces. I advise that when you are cleaning your shoes, always remove the shoelace so that you can clean those separately, as you'll see it toward the end of the video, or toward the middle of the video, excuse me. And then you can just clean the entire shoe, tongue included, and on the inside. So what I'm doing now is inserting a shoe tree, of course, because it reshapes the shoe, and you can see that's the original shape of the shoe. I have my water, my tap water. It don't have to be distilled water because we cleaning shoes for you bougie people. Me. My squeeze bottle was tripping, so I had to work on it. But with these being all leather, I'm starting with the soft bristle brush, and I'm just going around the entire shoe. And then after that, I'm gonna follow up with the medium bristle. The medium bristle is made for leather shoes because it really gets in the grooves and the crevices of the entire shoe. So after I use the medium bristle brush, I am going to use the hard bristle brush for the midsoles and the soles. As you can see, it was so satisfying cleaning this shoe because you can see the shoe becoming white again just by cleaning it. And as I progress in the video, the most satisfying part to me was cleaning the sole, because I did about half of the sole to show just what it looked like just with cleaning with the products. Now this is my favorite brush, the brass bristle brush, because I use that on the toe cap as well as the entire sole to get it as white as possible, and you'll see how white they become when I progress in the video. So now what I'm getting ready to do is remove the shoe tree so that I can clean the entire inside of the shoe. And you know, that's where my foot go. Now I do wear socks, so don't get it twisted. It wasn't that dirty, but you know, I never clean a shoe halfway. I clean it, you know, inside and out. Now that the insides are done, I flip the shoe over and look at the sole. Now look at this before and after, y'all. You can just see I just hit it with the hard bristle brush. I went back to the hard bristle to start on these soles. And what I'm gonna do is wipe them off so you can see, like, hey, look, you can even see that before I wiped it off. Just half the shoe is getting back to where it should be versus where it was. But even after using the hard bristle brush, I used the brass brush. And once it came out of the washer, it was immaculate. So now that the shoe is clean, I'm going to focus on the shoestring, and all you do is just dip it in the solution and you rub it in your hand. Now normally it gets more soapy than that, but because of the fabric of this shoestring, it wasn't nylon, so it didn't really get soapy. But what you're going to see me do is clean a certain spot with the soft bristle brush, because if you saw in the beginning, there was a huge stain on it. And once it got done cleaning in the washing machine, it was good as new. Now that the entire shoe is clean, I put it in a shoe bag along with the shoestring, and we're gonna stick it in the washer for a normal cycle, cold water, and just let it go. Oh my, look at that shoe. It's so white, y'all. Even without the light, it's just super white. But now the finishing touches is me just going with a paper clip and getting out the little rocks that get stuck in your shoe, because you don't want that stuck in your shoe. And we just gonna relace this bad boy up, and then I'll show y'all the before and afters. Thank you. Before I let you guys enjoy these before and afters, y'all do me a favor, like and subscribe and share this with your friends, you know? You know, because I know all y'all got dirty shoes out there. But look, I do appreciate you guys. And we out of here. And tell Tim to come back because I'm tired of doing these voiceovers. Amen.